I'm Professor Radisson. This is Philosophy 150, Introduction to Philosophical Thought. This semester, I propose that we refuse to waste our limited time together debating the existence of the big man in the sky, the useful fairy tale in ages gone by. I would like to bypass this senseless debate altogether and jump to the conclusion, which every sophomore is already aware of: there is no God. All that I require from each of you is that you fill in the papers I've just given you with three little words: God is dead, along with your signature. Assuming we reach a unanimous consensus, which I expect we will, I will be spared the tedious duty of slogging through dry and dusty arguments, and you will bypass the section of the course in which students have traditionally received their lowest grades of the semester. Oh, a lowercase g. Maybe this one ought to get extra credit.
I can't do what you want, I'm a Christian.
No, don't worry, you can still go back to your dorm room and sink to your knees and pray at your bedside if you'd like. If you cannot bring yourself to admit that God is dead, you will need to defend the antithesis, that God is not dead, and you'll need to do it in front of this class from the podium. And if you fail, as you shall, you will fail this section and lose 30% of your final grade right off the bat. But, you know, you could change your mind and bring in your signed statement at our next class, and we'll go forward as though none of this ever happened.
I've just been named partner.
I think I have cancer. Did you hear me? Did you hear what I just said?
This couldn't wait until tomorrow.
Argument. I mean, you can see
Jeffrey,
where he was going with
it. I need to talk to you.
You know how I feel about that. You know, on campus, I'm Professor Radisson, okay? So then he claims that Dawkins is the one who's in error. I know, as if Dawkins were saying that we need a God to be moral, that a moral atheist is an impossibility.
No, but with no God, there's no real reason to be moral. I mean, there's not even a standard of what moral behavior is.
If God does not exist, then everything is permissible.
Lies, lies, and more lies. Do you think you're smarter than me, Wheaton? Do you think there's any argument you can make that I won't have an answer for? I want to make this clear. In that classroom, there is a God, and yet I'm him. If you truly feel a need to continue with this charade, I will make it my personal mission to destroy any hope of a law degree in your future. Have a nice day.
I thought you loved me.
I do. But you're changing our agreement. You're breaking our deal.
You make it sound like a contract negotiation.
Well, what did you think this was?
Life is really a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury and signifying nothing.
Actually, it was great. But now it's over.
Religion is like it's like a mind virus. And Christianity is the worst virus of all.
We had fun. I was your upwardly mobile, charming, successful boyfriend.
I have no idea how much I'm gonna enjoy failing you.
I thought it was love.
Grow up, Amy. Love is what we say when we want something.
I hate God. All I have for him is hate.
You understand that I might die.
I'm sorry about that.
You really should go see Mom. She's not doing well.
She hasn't been doing well for years. That's why they call it dementia.
Still, you should go see her. Claire said you haven't been there in a while.
Like it matters? I'll make you a deal. You go and you ask her what 3 + 3 equals. If she gives you the right answer, I'll visit.
Say hi to Amy.
Oh, that's over. Unresolved personal issues. She's got some stuff she's got to work through.
I'm leaving you.
You can't do that. I won't accept it.
I won't allow it.
God is not dead.
God's not dead.
God's not dead. God's not dead.
Oh, that's perfect.
Do you know Jesus?
I'm an atheist.
I believe it's God's mercy that brought me here right now.
But I'm here to tell you that it's a gift. Because the God that you don't believe in has given you another chance. Another chance to change your final answer.
Stay with me. Stay with me. Are you willing to put your faith in Jesus
Christ?
Do you
accept him
as Lord and Savior?
Yes, I...
Speaking on behalf of the Robertson family, me and the gang wanted to let you know we've heard in the news that there's been a bit of a squabble down there on campus. One of your professors insisted that God is dead. I want everyone to go to their contacts and click on everybody you know and text them. Three simple words: God's not dead.
What happened here tonight is a cause for celebration.